Do you deliver on your promises? I noticed lately that lots of people have huge promises and then they fall short. Like in a hotel, if it's a six-star hotel and then the internet doesn't work in your room and they can't fix it, and you're in the middle of the night on a call. Thank God, you know, the phone works, data connection. And the next morning they say, yeah, we are going to fix it, and it's still not fixed. So I find this kind of a little bit annoying, and I train myself to not get too upset, but it is in a way because it disrupts. And probably, you know, if you're promising something and not fulfilling on this promise, it has an impact on other people's lives, right? They rely on you, maybe they trusted you, they acted upon your promise. So my question really for you, and the challenge for you this week, is take a closer look at yourself, take a closer look at all the things you promise, whether it's you to family members, maybe to kids, parents, significant other, whether it's your team members, whether it's to your friends, whether it's your customers, to your clients. I'd rather promise less and over deliver than promising the world and falling short. I know sometimes things happen, things which are out of our control. I get this. But I guess you know what I'm talking about. Because for some people, it seems like it's a habit, right? Big words, big promises, and then falling short. And very often, the environment is blamed. Other people are blamed. I don't know. It's the weather. I don't know. So my challenge for you as your mentor is, as your high performance coach, as your breakthrough coach, breakthrough to the next level, to be more of a leader, to be more of an expert, a person people go to, they look up to you, and not like, oh, it's not like they put you on a pedestal, but they come to you because they know you show up with integrity and they can rely on you. Hi, Mohammed. If you have any questions, please put them here. So the challenge this week really is, have a close look at yourself. Do you really follow up in 99% of the cases? Because I think 100%, this might be idealistic. Do you follow up on your promises? Do you promise people the world, and then every single time there is an excuse for not delivering, right? And let me know how this kind of gives you a new insight, how this maybe gives you a new vision on yourself. Because if you know how you function, if you know your shortfalls, if you're aware of those, you can change. You have the superpower of choice. You can decide to change and get a mentor, get a coach. If you don't know how to do this, get some professional help. Not just a friend, like, you know, just like chit-chatting. Get someone who knows what he or she is talking about. And really look closely how you promise. And if you find some pitfalls, if you find that in some areas you seem to overpromise, take it back. But still work your butt off to serve at the highest quality and over-deliver. And don't forget, my friends, always serve with an open mind and with an open heart. Hope this resonates with you. My name is Renate Prandl, and as a mentor and high-performance coach, my mission is to empower you to take obstacles, to turn obstacles into stepping stones, right? And to live a more sustainable and more highly integrated and fulfilling life. If this resonates with you, please share with your friends, share with your coworkers, post questions, comments below. And if you watch the replay and have a question, just hashtag replay and post questions and comments there as well. I'm happy to, if I can, to answer them in another feed or directly. And if you know that you need someone who holds your hand but also kicks you gently in your butt to get you moving, maybe high performance coaching could be the thing for you. It's by application only, so reach out to me, so like interest, next level or breakthrough, and we can probably schedule a 15-minute success activation call just to decide whether we are a good fit, and we take it from there. But even if you don't take it from there, you will get lots of insights. You will still get some actionable steps, I guess, out of this call. I'm here to serve you, my friends, because like the weather, it's same as the weather. The weather is really dreary right now. It's drizzling. It's miserable. It's awful, actually. I like warm weather. And it's the same for some people's lives. They are shut down. They are miserable. They don't see the light at the end of the tunnel. I'm here to serve you. I'm here to empower you. And I'm here to help you shift your mindset, your mission, and your moves. Thanks for watching. Dankeschön, auf Wiedersehen. Love you guys.